little guy.
Drinking.
Oh, thank you.
Drinking.
Did I miss something? When did we get to Disneyland?
All of it. It's all true.
So here's the Reddit that basically proves that the Mortis thing was going to happen. All right, guys, Stephanie Janicek, the Smuggler's Cantina. First off, I'm going to say this. JJ, I was wrong. It wasn't you who did this. You were in a contract. You did what you had to fulfill the contract. I'm going to show you guys some video.
Authorship of George Lucas and the world that he created. There was the mythic groaning that was written in the script. And I think, Kathleen, you once did away, or you didn't accept the first script that came. And because Lucas had written some parts of this saga, and also he's written a book. And would it be part of the Star Wars canon in the future?
By the way, catch a look on Oscar Isaac's face when they're talking about George. Look at Daisy. They're both looking at JJ, very upset. They know what's going on, okay? People who say the actors were oblivious are stupid, okay? The actors know exactly what happened, okay? Moment George Lucas is brought up, JJ looks visibly uncomfortable and upset. Go to this next one.
Don't like what happens or wish it was something different. Is there a problem with the fandom that...
No, I'd say that they're right. You know, the people who love it more than anything are also right. You know, we knew going in, I was asked just, I think, 7 hours ago in another country, someone said, so how did you go about pleasing everyone? And I was like, what? Like, not to say that that should be what anyone tries to do anyway, but how would one even go about it, especially with Star Wars? I mean, I don't need to tell anyone here. We live in a moment.
And trying very hard to just explain what's going on with this movie. When you look at it, it's a pieced together dumpster fire, and he knows that. Now, how did this happen? First off, JJ, I get it. I apologize. I really apologize from the bottom of my heart. I did not know this actually was the case. I know enough about Hollywood to have seen this coming. And nowadays, suits think they're part of the creative team. They use spreadsheets. They use votes. They go to Reddit and Tumblr and think that that's the audience. All right, fine. Movie looks like it's doing good with the audience scores, but when you look at the fans are pissed. All right? Fans are pissed. JJ knew this was going to happen. When he filmed this, when him and George, by the way, the thing that bothers me so much, that first clip I showed you, when George Lucas's name is brought up, he looks visibly upset. Kathleen Kennedy looks visibly uncomfortable, which is completely different. JJ looks like he wants to be sick because what he filmed was what George and him had talked about. They worked on this together, okay? And oh, by the way, I was right about Mortis. It was going to be the Mortis arc. And we were going to get Rey Solo. Which is what I think everybody in the fandom, when you pull back the onion, really, really, really want it, okay? Because it makes sense. It just makes sense. And here we go. Here's the Red. I'm not going to read it to you. Basically, what it is, and I posted it on the channel so you can actually read it. Here's what it is. Basically, JJ and Chris Terrio went to George Lucas. They made up a plan. They filmed what they filmed. they brought Matt Smith in to play the son of Mortis, and I knew that was going to happen. And this was going to be epic. I mean, this was, oh God, the money they could have earned on this from collectors. And my God, Sideshow Collectibles would have made tons of money on Son of Mortis figures. Hasbro. God. So they filmed it, and Iger, in his infinite wisdom, said, no, we need to appeal to the general audience. They'll be confused by this. Because general audience is stupid, right? Because Bob Iger sits here, right? He sits way up there. You're all dumber than I am. I know what I want to do, right? Bob Iger has never created anything in his life except for a big dump. Okay, this is this guy right here. So in his infinite wisdom, him and Kathleen Kennedy ordered the reshoots. The reshoots are all Palpatine. Now you might hear different voices, but in the end, it's still Palpatine. Now, Dark Rey hisses and turns, has fangs, but that's just her Sith side. That's not Son of Mortis. I mean, go sit over there and be quiet for a while, okay? If you actually think somehow this is indicating Son of Mortis is somewhere in this movie and he's not, okay? Because Bob Iger said no, because we can't market it, which is bullshit. Just market Ian McDiarmid. He was supposed to be the red herring anyway, you fucking idiot. I mean, how, you know, someday someone's going to have to explain to me how Bob Iger got this job, because he couldn't lead an ant army. I mean, he's worthless. He's useless. He doesn't know what the fuck he's doing. So they order these reshoots. They dump all of Matt Smith's, I'd love to see it, Matt Smith's scenes, cut everything that George shot, which is probably, and then disinvited him from the premiere, because you don't want that around, do you? After all, Bob, you not only backstabbed and screwed the guy over once, you screwed him over twice now, all right? Kathleen Kennedy did the same thing, all right? We'll protect these characters. # deadbeat dad, drunk deadbeat dad Han Solo. # Harpy Arid and Leia. # Exile coward Luke. That was her idea of protecting these characters. Well, I'm protecting these characters. All right. So she backstabbed him twice now too, because she and Iger both gave JJ and Terrio the go-ahead to go talk to Lucas. Okay. They showed up. They came up with a plan. It was going to fix everything that TLJ broke and make it bigger. Them and their infinite wisdom. All right. First off, we catered to Raylo. They catered to Raylo. Why? Because they think that the audience, the base of the fans, are a bunch of overweight, fat, stinky, smelly cat ladies, or stupid, uneducated, oversexed teenage girls who just want to sleep with Adam Driver. That's it. That's what they think their fan base is. All right? No, that's not the fan base. The fan base has been there for 43 years. The fan base understands the lore, the mythology. They would have gotten the Son of Mortis. General audience, here's what you missed, Bobber. Here's what you missed, Kathy. But you're such an idiot, you would miss it anyway. The Son of Mortis is one of the most popular characters in Star Wars. He is literally the culmination, the synthesis, everything of the dark side of the Force. Okay. You could have sold billions of dollars in merchandise on him alone. This is a character that could snap Palpatine's neck like a twig. He can switch into different beings. I mean, a little monster, Ahsoka as an older, as an adult, Anakin talking to Anakin, maybe Qui-Gon Jinn, Shmi Skywalker talking to Anakin. You know, But instead of giving Sideshow, Collectibles, Hasbro, all these huge companies that would have made a fortune on Son of Mortis figures and all the rest of that shit, you said no. Because you think you're catering to the general audience. I am livid. You've missed out on an opportunity to, A, market the Clone Wars on Disney Plus, all right? And get people interested in watching that who haven't seen it before. Because guess what, Bob? It's not made for kids. It's actually made for people who can actually understand the politics. Because it's a pretty complicated show. Duh. You could have marketed the Clone Wars and Disney Plus. You could have marketed the Son of Mortis himself. Have someone on your cast walk around Galaxy's Edge. All right. Instead, we got basically Rey Palpatine undermines the entire saga. Palpatine coming back. Just basically, you know, makes Anakin and Luke's arcs irrelevant. Rey Palpatine, you know, basically makes Han and Leia's romance irrelevant because Kylo Ren is a douchebag. All right? You made everything that George Lucas created irrelevant in this one fucking movie. This one fucking movie broke the entire canon. And I guarantee you, there are people that work at Lucasfilm that hate your guts for it. All right? There's no reason for it. And I know Bob will try to throw Kathy under the bus and Kathy will whatever. All right? I don't know. But, I mean, what I want to say here, Bob, you are the Mullah Omar of film CEOs. Okay? You might as well have blown up the Bamiyan Buddhas along with the Taliban. That's what you did. This is like burning the Library of Alexandria. All right. This is what you fucking did. All right. By sticking your nose where it doesn't belong in the creative process. People like you are the reason why George Lucas did not want to sell his franchise and his company in the first place. Now, I know why he did it. And I understand. He was wrong to trust you. His only mistake was thinking you were a friend and thinking Kathy Kennedy was a friend, and that's it. And every one of us have trusted bad people before, so I don't blame him for it. You lied to him. You stabbed him in the back. When you look at the way JJ reacts to hearing his name, he looks like he wants to cry. He had a good movie. It's probably the best movie he ever directed. Why? Because he had the maker himself helping. And you fucked it up. You fucked it up. And now there's nothing you can do about it. You know what I would do? Because you're going to be gone sooner than you think, Bobber. I would decanonize these movies. I would go to Dave Filoni and Jon Favreau. Here's your chance to fix what was broken. Go for it. And the only way you could do it and make it right without having to go and recast all the lead characters, Han, Leia, and Luke, as they do it digitally. All right? And you do what George Lucas wanted to do in the first place. Out of respect for him. All right? That's the only way you can fix it. Because you have broken everything. Decanonize, take the numbers off these goddamn movies, and admit you made a mistake. You know, here's what you really should do beyond that. Publicly apologize to George Lucas. Publicly apologize to Harrison Ford, Mark Hamill, Billy Dee Williams, Carrie Fisher's family. Publicly apologize to the fans for what you did. That's what you should do. All right. That's what a man would do. That's what a man would do. But I don't think a cultural terrorist like you, a sociopath, narcissist, freakazoid like you, would ever think to do that, because it would demean you. You're glorious. You know everything. Tell you what, do you think this movie's gonna make $1 billion? I don't think so. And if it doesn't, the shareholders are gonna wonder why. You know, it's really interesting. friend of mine, who's not a shareholder, actually listened in on the last meeting. Why did you avoid talking about Star Wars? Why? Why? I know why. Because you don't know what the fuck you're doing and you know it. They know you screwed up. You could also do this. Just tell George, here, here's your company back, buy it back. Or have taken the Paramount Universal offer and call it a day, which is what I think two of the board members and several of the shareholders wanted you to do. But no, you're a self-centered prick who thinks that you're right and everybody else is wrong. And it's mine, it's mine. Well, actually, dude, just because your company owns the IP doesn't mean it belongs to you. It belongs to everybody who sat down in a theater in 1977 through 2004. Sat down in front of the TV set when the Clone Wars series was going on. That's who it belongs to. Who bought the EU books. It doesn't fucking belong to you, even if you own the IP. And you owed everybody, all these people, George Lucas included, Harrison Ford, Carrie Fisher, Mark Hamill, Billy Dee Williams, Peter Mayhew, Kenny Baker, Anthony Daniels, an apology for fucking up 43 years of hard work, for screwing up characters that were heroic. You know, if you didn't want to use them, don't have them in the movie. Pay Harrison Ford off his big contract, Carrie and Mark, and then, you know, go off and do whatever the fuck you want. Oh, wait, I know why you did what you did. You wanted them there to bring people like me into the theater. And then you said, here's the backstab. Like a freak, because that's exactly what you did. You know, again, you're an executive. Stay out of the creative process. Keep your nose out of it, okay? Let JJ, Terrio, and George do what they do, all right? Because I'll tell you something. If I had gotten what I wanted, I'd have been on my fourth viewing of this movie. But no. You had to think you're smarter than they are. And guess what? Eventually, that's going to come and bite you in the ass. And it's going to bite Kathy Kennedy in the ass. Well, her betrayal of George is going to do it anyway. You are truly Bob Iger, the Mullah Omar of the film, of film. You are. You are the Mullah Omar of film IPs. You should be proud of yourself. That's a great company to keep. Really. You're a cultural terrorist. You're a barbarian. You're disgusting. JJ, I'm mortified. I'm so sorry. I apologize again. This was not your fault. You had a contract to fulfill. Bob Iger, someday the karmic debt you've built up is going to come back and hit you in the head. Hit you. And I'm going to be there to see it. Maybe it'll be you being arrested for SEC violations. I don't know. That would actually be pretty cool, seeing you frog walked out of the Disney offices by the FBI. Could happen. It's happened before. Think about it, Bob. Think about it. No one's untouchable, and no one's too big to fail. Steph sending out, Sierra on the Galaxy, Sierra on the Cantina. Remember, tip the Wookiee bartenders 20%. No droids, no bounty hunters, no Raylos. Fuck them. Thanks, Bob, for that. Really, thanks, Bob. What was wrong with Rey Solo again? Oh, wait, the trendies. We have to follow the trends. Fuck you and your trends. Star Wars is timeless, not trendy. Fuck off. Start, fight. Allie, gunfights, take the shot in the street. Shot in the galaxy.